The standard error we've been using assumes that the samples are approximately the same size. We must correct for the sample size first by pooling the variances. So now we're going to slightly change the standard error that we've been using. The pooled variance, which we'll denote S sub p squared, because remember that S squared was the variance and S was the standard deviation, is the average of the two sample variances that corrects for different sample sizes. Remember when we had one sample that the variance was the sum of squares divided by the degrees of freedom, which, written out, is the sum of the squared deviations divided by n minus 1. With pooled variances, we're doing almost the same thing. When we have two samples, we'll add the sum of squares for each, and then divide by the sum of the degrees of freedom. Let's go through an example. Let's say we have two samples, which we'll call x and y. We want to know if the populations that these samples are from are significantly different. First, find the sum of squares for each. Remember that to do this, you'll have to find each deviation from the mean, and then square them, and then add them up. You're welcome to write each deviation and squared deviation in these columns, but you don't have to. We just provide the boxes there so that that can help you as you calculate the sum of squares. But you can always use technology, Excel or R, whatever you want to use, or you can just do it by hand rather than typing them in. Whatever is easiest, as long as you get these sum of squares.